Schuller, attorney at law, and Hoosier Racing Tire, and let's go to Alan Todd.
Well, folks, we know trackside for our Winter Circus interview, Jeff Sparks. What an afternoon he's had. He's sponsored by Sparks Homes and Home Renovations Incorporated. Sharp looking automobile, this number 7. Ladies and gentlemen, race fans, as he takes the safety equipment off, trying to get that helmet off here at Showplace in the Carolinas. Beautiful afternoon, Jeff Sparks, our feature winner in the street stock division. Sharp looking automobile. Let's hear it for him as he puts his hat on. He's ready to exit out of this car. Ladies and gentlemen, your feature winner in the street stock division, let's hear it for Jeff Sparks.
Boy,
what an afternoon this gentleman had. He led each and every lap of this event, started on the pole, was quick qualifier for this afternoon. He's trying to get his shoes. I don't know, did you have your shoes off while you were in the car? That's what you call relaxed. Jeff, congratulations, second interview of the day with you. I tell you what, just an awesome race car this afternoon.
Yeah, it's pretty good. We're trying to get ready to go to Florence next week. And went down there, but I want to thank my dad, Brandon Davis, Ronnie, son, Jackson, Jay, my grandmother's here, my mom, we'll get back together and come back next week.
What's the secret to this car? I'm going to tell you what, this thing looked like it was on a reel. Do you guys do all your own chassis working off?
No, Brandon Davis does, but the secret to it is keeping throttle clean, because I demolished this thing a couple of times in a row in 2-day paint span, so she ain't hung back up and been fast pretty much since.
Well, Jeff Sparks receiving a winner's trophy on behalf of Caraway Speedway. Right there's the winner's trophy. I was looking for Miss Shea Van. She's not here with us. Jeff Sparks, congratulations on behalf of Caraway Speedway. Your feature winner, the street stock division. Let's move back to our second place finisher. Hey, he comes to us all the way from Plymouth, North Carolina, down on the coast. Mike Cooper, what a run you had today. Come home second in street stock division.
Well, we came in practice yesterday. Always run the best. We've been around here. We've run about 5 or 6 races. And we keep picking up a little bit. You know, Jack Lawrence coming here and just takes the wind around the tail. But that's okay. He's a major driver, and he's always smooth and good, and he's going to be there.
You said you were from Plymouth, North Carolina. How long did it take you to get here from Plymouth?
About 3 hours and 15 or so minutes.
Well, I'll tell you what, folks, that's just about as far east as you can go, isn't it?
Yeah, if you go home for about 1 hour and 10 minutes from Flag's End, which is as far as you can go.
Well, we're happy to have you with us. Congratulations on your feature. When are you going to be with us throughout the 2024 season?
Well, we'll come back probably in Thanksgiving. They don't run our class on the week of race, I don't think. But if they did, we want to come down here a little more.
There you go. That's the second place finisher. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going right back to the top of the tire for Wesley Outland and the late models coming up next.
Thank you very much, Alan Todd. And Mike Cooper, Super Coop, a multi-time champion at East Carolina Motor Speedway, Southern National, New River All-American, formerly known as Coastal Plains. The man has got an impressive resume in that car, Motorsports number 07 as well. And of course, when it's all said and done, the Ackworth, Georgia driver,